Hello everyone, in this video, the continuation of gastrointestinal embryological defects and the last three topics are intestinal atresia, hypertrophic pyloric stenosis, and the last one I will explain in this video is the pancreas and spleen embryology. So what is intestinal atresia? It presents with bilious vomiting and abdominal distension within first 1 to 2 days of life. So I repeat, what is intestinal atresia? It presents with bilious vomiting, means vomiting occurs very rapidly and abdominal distension occurs within the first 1 to 2 days of life. So duodenal atresia, failure to recanalize. It is the failure to recanalize the duodenum, and abdominal x-ray shows the double bubble appearance, means dilated stomach and proximal duodenum. It is associated with the Down syndrome. Next is the jejunal and ileal atresia. Jejunal and ileal atresia means it is a disruption of mesenteric vessels, typically superior mesenteric artery, that is ischemic necrosis of fetal intestine, that is segmental, ultimately leads to segmental resorption. I repeat, the disruption of mesenteric vessels leads to jejunal and ileal atresia, typically superior mesenteric artery, ultimately leads to ischemic necrosis of fetal intestine, that ultimately leads to segmental resorption. And the bowel becomes discontinuous or assumes a spiral configuration, that is apple peel appearance. So what it look like in x-ray? The dilated loops of small bubbles with air fluid levels. So it is a intestinal atresia. And next one is the hypertrophic pyloric stenosis. So it is the most common cause of gastric outlet obstruction in infants, 1:600 ratio. So it is the palpable olive shaped mass in epigastric region, visible peristaltic waves and non-bilious projectile vomiting at 2 to 6 weeks old. So I repeat, it is the most common cause of gastric outlet obstruction in infant, that is 1:600. Palpable olive shaped mass in epigastric region, that is visible peristaltic waves and non-bilious projectile vomiting at 2 to 6 weeks old. So it is more common in first born males associated with exposure to macrolides, and it results in hypokalemic, hypochloremic, metabolic alkalosis. It is secondary to vomiting of gastric acid and subsequent volume contraction. So ultimately it leads to hypokalemic, hypochloremic, metabolic alkalosis. On ultrasound examination, it represents as thickened and lengthened pylorus. So what is the treatment? Surgical incision is the treatment, and pyloromyotomy. It is a pyloromyotomy. And the last topic is the pancreas and spleen embryology. So pancreas, it is derived from the foregut and from the ventral pancreatic duct, contributes to uncinate process and main pancreatic duct. So the dorsal pancreatic duct alone becomes a body, tail, isthmus and accessory pancreatic duct. Both ventral and the dorsal buds contribute to pancreatic head. So I repeat, the two types of pancreatic buds are there. Dorsal bud becomes a body, tail, isthmus and accessory pancreatic duct. Ventral pancreatic bud contributes to uncinate process and main pancreatic duct. So pancreas derived from the foregut. So annular pancreas, it is the abnormal rotation of the ventral pancreatic bud, forms a ring of pancreatic tissue that ultimately encircles the second part of duodenum. It may cause duodenal narrowing and vomiting. So pancreas divisum, it is the second one. So these are the annular pancreas and pancreas divisum are the embryological defects. And pancreas divisum, it is the ventral and dorsal parts fail to fuse 8 weeks. It is a common anomaly, mostly asymptomatic. It may cause chronic abdominal pain or pancreatitis. So another pancreas, it is abnormal rotation of ventral pancreatic bud, form a ring of pancreatic tissue, and it encircles the second part of duodenum. It may cause duodenal narrowing and vomiting. And the pancreas division is the ventral and dorsal parts fails to fuse at 8 weeks. It is a common anomaly. It is mostly asymptomatic, and it may cause chronic abdominal pain and pancreatitis. So the next is the spleen. It arises in the